Welcome everyone to this video on the cattle problem from ancient Greece. The cattle problem is actually a poem, and in the two manuscripts where it's preserved, there's a heading that says that Archimedes either found or invented it and sent it to the scholars of Alexandria. It's quite a detailed heading, but in general, things like this are not thought to be especially reliable. But whether or not Archimedes wrote the poem, we can say that it's very much in the spirit of his maths. Just like in his works called Sand Reckoner and Stomachion, which I'm hoping to do videos on very soon, the poem connects the maths of big numbers to an engaging and non-specialist idea. And I say that because this problem takes as its starting point a couple of lines from Homer's Odyssey, a text that anyone reading this poem in ancient Greece would have known from more basic levels of education. One of Odysseus' adventures involves getting stranded on the island where the sun god kept his herds of cows and his flocks of sheep. And his men, Odysseus' men, are told that they cannot eat these sacred animals, but the gods strand them there for so long that eventually they get bored of fishing and they can't resist a nice meal, and they die shortly afterwards. Now, in the Odyssey, there are just seven herds of cows, each containing 50 animals. And our problem converts this into a much, much more complicated bit of maths. We're told that the cows are split into four herds based on colouring. They're black, white, brown, or mixed. And each herd has both male and female animals, so there are eight quantities overall. And we need to find values for those quantities based on some information about how they relate to each other. Now, pretty early on, readers of the Odyssey started identifying the island where the cows are in Homer, it's called Thrinakia, with Archimedes' homeland, Sicily. And Sicilian rulers were actually famous for keeping large herds of cows as a form of wealth. So one way to look at the problem would be as a sort of rather cheeky challenge from someone in Sicily to the intellectuals in Alexandria, who were the leading experts on literary questions, like where the Odyssey took place, asking them effectively to put a figure on Sicily's wealth. Anyway, let's get into the maths of the problem. First, we're told the relationships between the number of bulls of each colour. One thing you'll notice if you compare my discussion with, say, the Wikipedia entry about this problem, is that some of the coefficients differ. For example, in the third equation here, I've got effectively an 11 20ths that most accounts of the problem omit, and that's because the meaning of the ancient Greek text is not completely clear. I'm presenting what seems to me the most likely meaning linguistically, whereas there's a long tradition, which probably goes back at least to late antiquity, of making what I think is a rather debatable assumption that the problem must originally have intended the pattern of coefficients to be extremely, extremely neat, regardless of whether or not that's what the Greek, as it's handed down in the two manuscripts, says. But to be honest, the coefficients don't really alter any of the steps needed to solve the problem, so that's more of an aside. So to use modern terms, the first part of the problem is a system of linear equations. We're going to have seven in total and eight unknowns. And of course, we would tackle this using algebra, but the Greeks didn't actually have algebra that could deal with eight unknowns at once. So let's just think, how would Archimedes have tackled this? And I think it's most likely that he would have represented each quantity as the length of a line, because with geometrical diagrams, the Greeks were familiar with the idea of representing lots of unknown quantities. This is actually a standard move in Archimedes' own work, for example, in On Spirals, where he needs to add up the first n perfect squares. He represents them literally as squares and rectangles attached to them. So in this way of thinking, we translate the equations into a diagram a bit like this. If the line AB represents the number of black bulls, we scale it down by 5/6 using similar triangles, then we add on CE to represent the number of brown bulls. So overall, the line DE represents the number of white bulls. We scale that down to FG and add on the number of brown bulls again to make FH. This time that's representing 11 20ths of the mixed coloured bulls. And we can scale that by 9 11ths to make the line JK. And once more, add on the brown length to give JL. And the problem tells us, effectively, that the line JL has the same length as AB. And what we can do using the diagram is keep track of the various scalings and split JL into segments, each of which is fairly simple multiple of either AB or CE. And so when we put all that together, we can get the correct ratio of AB to CE. And we could then continue to express the ratios of DE and F dash H dash, which would be the overall number of mixed bulls, to CE. So that's one method. An alternative that would be available at least a few centuries after Archimedes, if not before, the Greeks did have a sort of proto-algebraic system that could be used in contexts like this. And in fact, there are some quite similar problems near the end of book one of Diophantus, who is our main source for this. This approach, it only has one unknown symbol, but it is able to deal with a problem like this with eight unknown quantities. And one of Diophantus' favorite tricks for doing this is to spot when problems have scalable solutions, which this one does. In other words, any set of rational numbers that satisfies these equations can be scaled up or down, and it will still be a solution if you multiply it by a constant factor. This means that we can assume in our case that one of the unknowns is any particular constant we choose. So for example, we can say that, let's say the number of brown bulls is one, and then we'll sort out all of the fractions a bit later. So if we assign our unknown symbol, which we'll say is n, to the number of white bulls, then we work through the equations, we have the number of black bulls is 6n over 5 minus 6 over 5. The number of multicolored bulls, based on adding up the second and third equations, would come to 6n over 5 minus 6 over 5 plus 13n over 42. So you can add those fractions up. But if we calculate the number of multicolored bulls just based on the second equation, we also get that it's 20 over 9 multiplied by 6n over 5 minus 11 over 5. And it's fairly elementary to get from these two equations, work out the fractions, and we find that n has the value 2324 over 729. We can substitute that value back into the other equations and scale up until we get an integer solution, because of course the number of bulls is actually whole numbers in each case, and the integer solutions turn out to be multiples of white bulls being 6972, black being 5742, the brown ones being 7900, and the mixed coloured ones 2187. And you might like to just pause the video and check that you get those numbers as well. So that initial set of simultaneous equations about the bulls then gets extended with four further ones that deal with the number of female cows. Now, again, I've highlighted in red a couple of points here where my interpretation of the Greek isn't quite the same as the most common one. But we're not going to spend any time talking about those points of interpretation for the purposes of this video. The geometrical approach that I showed you before would work here, but it would make rather a tangled diagram. So I thought what we'd do is continue with the more Diophantine approach that we were using just now. We've still got a scalable problem. So what we're going to do is repeat our assumption that one of the unknown quantities is a constant that we can set now and worry about scaling later. So we're going to set the number of black bulls to 5,742, which is the number that we came up with before. And we'll reuse the unknown symbol n now for the number of black cows as opposed to bulls. And using just the same process as before, we can go through the equations, express the number of white cows in terms of n, then the number of brown cows, then the number of mixed cows, and then we get all the way back round to expressing n in terms of itself, the number of black cows. So in fact, we would end up with n being equal to n times 143 over 1200 plus 229,031 over 30. I won't go through every step of the calculations. That allows us to extract a value for n, and again, we can work out all of the other quantities based on that and scale up until we get integer solutions. And this whole process, if you think about what it would have been like in ancient Greece, no calculators or anything to help you out, it would have been quite laborious to work through it using long multiplication and then checking. And if you want to have a go, it certainly took me a few attempts to get the correct answers. When we do scale up, what we find is that integer solutions for these eight quantities are proportional to the numbers that I brought up on screen there. And this means that we've solved the first part of the cattle problem. And at this point, the poem says, "We may be said not to lack knowledge or ability with numbers," which is very nice of it. But then immediately it adds, "But you are not yet to be counted among the wise." And there's actually a harder bit of the problem to come. And the harder bit of the problem is as follows. "The white and the black bulls taken together can stand in a perfect square, while the brown and mixed coloured bulls taken together would stand in a triangle." In other words, their total number is a triangle number. Again, we're going to use results from Diophantus to imagine how Greeks, maybe not Archimedes, but later Greeks, might have tackled this problem. So far, we've got what Diophantus would call a solution in indefinite form for the numbers involved here. So we have that the square, the number of white and black bulls together, is some multiple of 120,948,282, based on my interpretation of what the Greek text says. And the brown and mixed coloured bulls taken together, the triangle number, is 95,957,631, again times the same multiple. So what sort of multiple should we look for? Well, if we take the fact that the first one is a square, what we should do is factorize this large number, 120 million, etc., etc., and we can take out the factors. That will tell us, if we've got to multiply that by m to make a square, then m is going to need to be divisible by 2 and 7 and 13 and 151 and 163 and by 3 at least, and then by some other square factor potentially. So we can say that m has a particular form, some multiple of k squared for some other integer k. So we've got this enormous multiple of k squared being m, and then we multiply that by another big number, nearly 96 million, to get a triangle number. Now, triangle numbers are not so easy to deal with as square numbers, but what we can do is use a nice result, which again is in Diophantus, and that is that 8 times any triangle number plus 1 is a square number. And you might like to just pause the video and prove this algebraically. It's not too difficult if you know how triangle numbers work. But what I've given you is a sort of quick visualization that shows that 8 lots of 6, which is a triangle number, plus 1 is 7 squared, just diagrammatically. And if you think about this diagram for a moment, you should hopefully see that it can be scaled up to different triangle numbers. If we apply that reasoning, 8 times a triangle number plus 1 is a perfect square, the problem actually boils down to the following. 8 lots of the brown and mixed bulls, which is an enormous multiple of k squared, is one less than a perfect square, and you've got to find a suitable k that will give a solution for that. Now, my guess is that Archimedes would have understood the cattle problem well enough to see that it had that general structure. It's finding a huge multiple of one square being one different from another square number. And I think Archimedes would have known that that type of problem is an intriguing question. Several Greek mathematical sources actually tackle the problem of when 2 times a square is one less than another square. And Archimedes himself shows some familiarity with the problem of when 3 times a square is one less than another square. And I've discussed that in one of my videos on his text, Measurement of the Circle. The series of solutions that the Greeks generated, they then used to find rational approximations for the square roots of 2 and 3, and it may well have been that that would have led them to experiment with other numbers, a bit bigger than 2 and 3, still not very big though, and maybe they noticed that even a number like 13, it's actually quite difficult to get going and find any solutions at all. And so I think it's quite plausible that a mathematician of Archimedes' period would have recognized this part of the cattle problem as a difficult, unsolved, and interesting problem. However, I do think it's extremely unlikely that any Greek could actually solve it. A pretty powerful method was eventually developed in India in the 11th and 12th centuries. It actually took until the 18th century for Lagrange to prove that a rather similar method actually always worked. Whenever there are solutions, it would find them. And it took until the rise of computers for anyone to actually present a specific number that, on one interpretation of the Greek text, would actually be a solution of Archimedes' problem. It's got hundreds of thousands of digits. Now, I'm going to explore some of the more technical maths involved in this last part of the problem in my next video, but for now, I hope you found it interesting in this video to hear a little bit about this problem and about some ancient ways of dealing with simultaneous equations. Thank you.